Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Students at Seabrook Elementary and Middle Schools, they have the day off from class today. School officials decided to cancel for today over concerns of the ice and the snow buildup on rooftops. Parents will be notified Sunday evening if there is no school on Monday. It has already been a long week of cleaning up, and these latest two storms have put a lot of snow blowers in the shop. At Superior Power Equipment in Manchester, they have about 50 machines that need repairs. The manager says the issues range from simple fixes like shear pins to much bigger problems. At Nalt's Power Sports, they've been working on about 20 snow blowers a day.
Belts. A lot of people are blowing belts, shear pins. A lot of people are hitting a lot of ice. And that's just really common right now with the amount of snow we have.
The manager says that they're sold out of snowblowers and won't be getting any more in this season. At Nalt's, 40 machines are on the way, but half of those are pre-sold. Attorneys for the man who admitted to taking part in a deadly home invasion in Mount Vernon are expected to go before a judge today. Christopher Gribble has pleaded not guilty by reason of insanity to the 2009 stabbing death of Kimberly Cates and the brutal attack on her daughter. Today, Gribble's attorneys are scheduled to appear at a hearing to work out the final details of his trial. Jury selection is set to begin next week, and the trial is set to get underway on February 28th. A two-alarm fire in Henniker has left two people without a place to live. This is amateur video from the scene. The fire broke out at noon yesterday, but luckily no one was at home at the time, so there were no injuries. Fire officials say this was caused by a wood stove that was not installed properly. While the house is still standing, there is severe damage on the inside. The Radisson in Nashua is back open after abruptly closing earlier this week. Managers blamed severe plumbing problems for Monday's shutdown and said that they could take weeks to fix. Those with reservations, weddings, and major conferences were forced to scramble. Well, now the hotel says the plumbing issues have been resolved, but a copy of a lawsuit obtained by News 9 indicates the closure may have been a result of cash flow issues. Either way, customers aren't happy, and at least one bride-to-be says she's taking her reception elsewhere.
I don't care. I'm done. I don't trust them. I've got out-of-town guests. They can't book reservations. I can't sit here for 6 months and go, well, what if?
The New Hampshire Orchid Society is also feeling some whiplash. The hotel's closure forced it to cancel its annual show. Now that it has reopened, members aren't sure whether to bring their business back to the Radisson. And that's it for your morning webcast. We do hope you can join us for more news today on News 9 at noon. Take care.